Today on Chat with Kat, we have a dancer, choreographer, director, and artist. She started Step Up 5, dropped an EP in 2016, published an autobiography, Young Queen, and most recently signed to IMG Models. She began dancing at 10 years old and soon after created Request Dance Crew. By 17, she had established the Palace Dance Studio in New Zealand and since then has won championship titles with her dance company, Royal Family. Her credits include Janet Jackson, Jennifer Lopez, Kanye West, Nicki Minaj, Rihanna, Ariana Grande, Sam Smith, Jason Derulo, and Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber's Sorry music video, directed and choreographed by her, has over 3 billion views on YouTube. Her work for Rihanna's Fenty line has revolutionized fashion shows, and most recently, she choreographed the Super Bowl halftime show for Jennifer Lopez. To top it off, this year she was appointed a member of the New Zealand Order of Merit for services to dance. And she announced her partnership with Sony Pictures to direct a film adaptation of her 2013 stage show, Murder on the Dance Floor. The unique, empowering, and beautiful Parris Goebel. Wow. Wow.
Hi, guys.
Hi. How you doing, Pete? Okay. How things are
going? Self-isolating, New Zealand.
Right. Is it weird or does it feel okay?
It probably feels similar to you guys. I mean, the only place we can go is the supermarket.
Right.
So, I mean, I'm grateful to be with family and to be with my nieces and nephews, so I'm a little bit more sane than I would be if I was in LA.
You were actually here in LA right when everything happened, I remember.
Yeah, I was, and then I just didn't feel completely safe over there, and I knew if I came home, I would feel a little more calm and
absolutely. I'm so happy that you're taking the time to do this. We see you everywhere, so now we get to hear, you know? Okay, my first question for you is, did you have like a huge dream growing up? Like, what was your biggest dream?
Do you know what, for me, I just have such distinct memories of watching MTV as a little girl. Like, that was kind of my only source of entertainment. Because honestly, we didn't grow up with YouTube and Instagram. It was a whole other world. So for me, I remember watching music videos, obsessing over them. I would record them, play them back. And for me, when I was little, I just think I had such a big dream to be a part of music videos. Yeah. That was, I have to do that one day. One day I have to be on that screen. I need to be behind that artist. Like, that was kind of it for me. And then I guess the more I was exposed to, the more I was like, my dreams kind of grew and evolved.
Right. I want to know, did someone give you your first big break? Some people have told me, like, my goodness, that tour was the
first show with you.
See, I remember that like it was yesterday. I literally do.
Me too.
Wow.
And me too. That was literally it. I mean, before that, I was living in New Zealand.
So that was actually Jennifer Lopez and Jamie King.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, like that whole moment, because you did the video and then you went on to doing the tour.
Wow. Yeah.
That is your first big break, and it's a huge one. Wow, how full circle.
I think I was 19, and she must have, I think Casper brought me to her attention from a video on YouTube that I did with Kyle Vanagami. We were sitting down, and we like used our hands. And
I remember that video.
I don't know if you remember this.
I do.
She must have seen that and been like, I have to get this girl for my tour. And I mean, the process was still kind of like how it would work as if I was a choreographer in LA. Like, I still had to submit.
Okay.
So I remember getting together like my company, and it was just the biggest ordeal. It was like, I put together a few pieces to her music. I sent it through, and it was like the next day I was like, okay, cool, she's gonna fly you over, and it's we're gonna use you. And of course, like, it went from like a week's worth to a month's worth to have seen all the pieces.
Do you feel like you were prepared for that? Or was it all very new?
It was so new. It was so new to me. I felt like everything I had done with my company prepared me for that moment.
Yeah. But,
I mean, working with you guys, like working with such experienced dancers, I had never been in that position before. I was the youngest in the room. I had never been in front of a mega, mega superstar in my entire life. Like, I'm from New Zealand. So, it was so crazy. And I think it was so many times I had to just tell myself, like, just
breathe.
You got this.
Breathe.
Chill.
Yeah.
You were made for this.
Yes.
Even though I felt like a fish out of water, I just had to remind myself you were made for this.
Absolutely. Okay, so your style is like, it's Paris. Like, it's become such... there is nothing else like it, right? So do you feel like you were inspired by things? Did it happen naturally, or did people bring it to your attention, like, hey, you have a style?
Yeah, it was kind of like that. Like, I didn't realize I was so unique. I really didn't. I felt like growing up in New Zealand was played so positively on my kind of the way I move, because I was so far away from kind of the industry.
Yes.
And I was so limited to what I could see. Like, I didn't really know what was hot. Mm. I didn't know what was cool, what was hot. I couldn't follow anything. So it turned out to be like the biggest blessing for me.
Yeah.
Because I would just be in my room, I'd put the music on, and I would just be like, just what do I want? What do I want to do? How do I want to move? And I would have started choreographing at like maybe 10 years old. Like, I always had like a bit of a thing for it.
Wow.
Even though I didn't recognize it as choreographing, you just think you're just
moving, like you're just dancing.
Yeah, you're just dancing. You're just like trying to make your step touch together.
Yeah.
And then it wasn't until I started posting my work on YouTube and people were like, this is so unique, this is so fresh, that it kind of made me realize, okay, maybe I have something special going on here. And by then I had already been doing what I do for years. So it wasn't like I all of a sudden was like, okay, now I'm going to do my thing. I had been doing
it. Right. It was just like brought to your attention more.
Exactly. Like, I didn't really realize like that I was different.
Yeah. I remember... it was like in your studio and you were going in slow motion.
Yeah. It was like a red light and it was to play.
Wow.
We did so much for like 3 minutes.
Yes. Well, I actually remember watching it going like, this is in post in slow motion, right? And then later, they're moving all together. That was, for me, like, that was you, you know?
Yeah, I mean, we even did that in my studio in New Zealand. So we were making all these clips from here, from New Zealand, and just kind of putting it out into the world. And I think it was like that. There was also like a video I did with the I Love Cali Boys, with all the boys in LA. They were like just kind of, they were just little moments that I think define me as an artist. Which
what motivated you?
I just had such an itch to create content that represented me, and like I couldn't control it. I would hear music, and I wouldn't just see movement, I would see concepts.
The whole thing.
Like, I just couldn't control it. And it's like I had to do it.
Okay, so I know that it's always hard to pick a favorite. So that's not the idea. It's not like a favorite. But is there, geared to your choreography, is there like one piece of work or like performance that you feel the most proud of?
That's kind of an easy one. I would say it would be... the show, the Fenty Savage show I just did with Ree last year for New York Fashion Week. That, I mean, what that did for women all over the world, I think, is something I'll be proud of forever. And yeah, it just, the messages I was getting brought me to tears. It was such a game changer.
Absolutely. I
love
that. I was
really proud of that show.
You should be. It was incredible.
A lot of hard work, but worth it.
You're so good under pressure, because I've worked with you and I've seen it, but do you remember any like cutthroat, like make it work moment in your career? Like,
I mean, suggested, I mean, there's so many words that come to mind. I'm like, so many. But Justin Bieber, Purpose, the movement project was one of the hardest things I've ever done.
So you directed how many, 12 or 13?
12. Oh, I feel like it was 13. I think it was 13 so. In like 3 weeks.
Right. And you came up with concepts, choreography, like everything.
I mean, sometimes I come up with the concept the day before I meet.
I remember that time.
Yeah, it was, that was really, really challenging for me, but that was good. But I think, I mean, honestly, the two most difficult jobs I've done was probably the Super Bowl.
Right.
And the Savage Show. So the like the most, my most recent work
has been
the most challenging.
Do you think that you apply some of that pressure to yourself?
I mean, yeah. Definitely.
A combination, right?
It's a combination, but I'm such a perfectionist that it's like I won't sleep at night if I don't feel good about how rehearsal has been or the work I kind of put together that day. If it wasn't like up to my standard, I really wouldn't sleep at night.
Yeah, and I feel like knowing, because I've worked with you, you need to see it happen. It's true though, like you can't just move on. You're like, if it's not good, I'm gonna keep changing it until that moment is great. It's so true.
Yeah
you're like version 105. Yeah, it's so cool. It is your thing. Yes, it really, really, really is your thing. Okay, what is something most people don't know about you?
That's a tough question. I mean, with social media, I probably share so much, but probably just my love for my family is the most important thing to me in life. So family, and I think there's no job or any experience that can compare to like the time I spend with my family.
Yeah, and now that you're in LA more than ever, I'm sure it's like harder to balance that, right?
Oh, I get so homesick, and it really does pull at my heart a lot. So
you said social media, and it made me think. I feel like you're definitely one of those people who are accessible through social media. You do connect a lot. Is it hard sometimes to find the balance?
Man, it's been such a journey to kind of feel that out and filter what I do when I share and what I don't. But I think the power of social media is it's your choice.
Yes.
You share what you want at the end of the day. So I always have to remind myself, this is my life. This is my page, you know, and I can do what I want. And even in an expressive way, like things that I post, it's up to me. I don't have anyone on my team like saying you should post this. It's always organic, and it's like it's just based on how I feel. So I think reminding myself I'm in control of that, it empowers me to either share or not share.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, what is one thing you could not live without?
Oh my gosh, lip gloss.
That's amazing.
Really, like if I'm not wearing lip gloss, I just feel chapped. I can't even step out of
the door.
House. Like I have one in the car, one in my, like three in my bag. It's really a thing. It is a thing.
That
sounds so like lip gloss.
Lip gloss. I see you as someone not attached to a certain look. Is there a haircut or a moment that you're like, we're not gonna go back there again?
You know what? I think I did a mullet once.
Wait, you know, Halsey has a mullet.
She suits everything, though.
You do too.
No, it was curly.
Okay, I understand a little bit.
Yeah.
We're not going back there again?
No.
Wow. Okay, and then if you just had any advice that comes right to mind.
I would say to take advantage of everything that we have in this generation. Like take advantage of social media, of all these new platforms. Use them and use them wisely. I think the amount of people are saying like, oh, how do I do this, how do I do that, it's like, man, the world we live in, it's like there's no excuse.
It's accessible
and you can put your work out there. in so many different ways. You can be seen, you can be heard, and there's just no excuse anymore. Mm.
Okay, my last question for you. What makes you feel the most alive?
That's easy, dance.
Dance.
That's easy. Mm. I think anyone that moves or dances knows the exact feeling. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's interesting because I was even watching like tapes of a tour we did last night. I just came across those old footage and I didn't even recognize myself. Like, you know, when you move, it's, you transform and you transport into a whole other space and time. Like, it was a beautiful moment because I don't really watch old tapes like that, but I was like, wow. I felt emotional because I was like, that girl is so free. She's on fire. She's fearless. Like, it was a really cool moment just watching old tapes. Like,
wow.
Yeah, to be able to express yourself to a point where there's no walls and there's no limitations, I think is a superpower that we have as dancers.
I love that. Well, I want to thank you for taking the time to talk to me.
I was so excited. I was like, yeah, I get to talk to someone.
I'm so happy that you took this time. I want to thank you personally for all that you are doing in our industry, for the community, for women. Paris, you are one of a kind, and
you're gonna make me cry. Thank you.
Cry. Feel how you feel, but you have to hear it. It's incredible what you're doing for our industry. I applaud you for being yourself in every single way. As a friend, I love you, and I am just so proud of you. Like, to really now know that your first big break I was a part of, it makes me feel 10 times more connected to you.
It's so full circle. Yeah. It's crazy.
Thank you for taking the time and being on Chat with Kat.
I love that.
Bye.